Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. This was co recorded on 2/22/2024. I'm being an idiot and honestly did not even realize that my mic was off in this intro clip. But yeah, guys, what we got planned out in this vlog today is we obviously we're day trading. We had no work this day, and then we hit a back day later in the video, guys. So stay tuned for the back day later in the video. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and yeah, guys, let's get it. Okay, guys, it's about 9:02 a.m. right now. Back inside, obviously. Let's go ahead and get on the charts and get all my levels I'm marked out. Sorry, and get all the levels I'm watching marked out on the chart for today, guys. Let's do it. Okay, guys, we have about 9 minutes till market open. So let's go ahead and go over the levels we have here on SPY, QQQ, and AMD today. We're honestly probably not even going to be watching SPY today, but we can go over it. We're probably just going to be watching QQQ, AMD, and IWM are the three main ones we're going to be watching today. I honestly haven't been playing SPY at all recently, so let's just go ahead and go over what we got here on QQQ right now since we're on it. You know, with NVIDIA having earnings yesterday and their earnings being so good, they beat earnings. You know, NVIDIA is such a large portion of the market and the overall NASDAQ that, you know, if NVIDIA has a big-ass move up, it's going to carry the market up. So that's why the market is so up this morning and why SPY is making all new all-time highs. So yeah, I'm going to be watching to see if we can break and hold above this 435.18 level on QQQ for potential longs up into 437.43. If we get a rejection around this level, I would like to see a pullback down into 430-ish, maybe down to 432-ish would be a really nice opportunity for a pullback, and then look for longs there.
That's pretty much all we're watching there on QQQ. For AMD, it's kind of a messier chart, for me at least. The levels aren't as clear as on like SPY and QQQ. But yeah, I'm going to be looking for a possible rejection, maybe up at around this level that we're at now, up at around that 470. It looks like we rejected literally right at 175-ish. We had that rejection right at 175, so I'm going to be looking for pullbacks maybe down into like 168.57-ish if we do continue to reject that level and get a bit of a sell-off into open and throughout the day. Look for longs potentially off that level, or look maybe even to catch some of this pullback, but I got to be cautious taking shorts and into a demand and support zone. So that's what we're going to be watching out for here on AMD today. And the last one is IWM. Levels are pretty clear today on IWM. What am I going to be watching out for is us for us to continue to have this rejection of this one almost 200-ish level here on IWM. Maybe look for a pullback down into 196.45-ish. Look for longs off this level. Also, maybe even see if we can catch some of this downside in this pullback here on IWM if we do continue lower. If we get a bounce around here, I'm going to be looking for longs up and above 199.7. But yeah, that's pretty much everything we're watching today, guys. That's all I really got for you guys this morning. We're going to crush and kill the market today, guys. We have to stay emotionless, and like we have to bounce back on the account, guy. I mean, we're still up for the overall year, and I think still for the overall month. But like, guys, we've got to lock in, man. We've got to today, man, and just, you know, the rest of the month and next month, we've got to, bro. We've got to. So. Yeah, with that being said, like I said, I'll keep you guys updated throughout the day if we take any trades. Yeah, let's get it. Okay, guys, it is about 9:57 a.m. right now, and I have a little bit of an update for you guys. And another red day, guys. Another red day. We've had a red day every single day this week. It's actually crazy. We actually did start out this morning with a winning trade here on IWM. I seen us closing this 5-minute candle here above VWAP. Very strong 5-minute bullish candle closing above VWAP. And then we took profit up and around this area since we were longing into resistance and supply zone. I knew this would be a riskier trade, so that's why we cut that for a quick win. And then here on QQQ was actually looking like a very, very good setup. Here, let me go ahead and show you. Okay, so what I was seeing us doing here on QQQ was having a breakout above this level here. This resistance and supply zone I was talking about earlier. Pre-market, probably when I was telling you guys about my levels, I seen us closing this 5-minute strong bullish candle above VWAP, above this level. It was looking very, very promising, very good. I was very confident in this trade. Took longs. I was up about almost 20%. Didn't take profit because I knew we probably still had a little bit more room up to the upside, but we obviously didn't. We had a strong rejection around that zone, and I got stopped out. Got stopped out as soon as we closed this 5-minute candle below this level and almost below VWAP. So yeah, another red day. I'm probably done trading for the day because that's one. Okay, so I guess just technically one loss. But yeah, pretty much it for the day, guys. I'm pretty sure we're done trading. It's only about 10 a.m. I'll keep you guys updated throughout the day. I only trade if I really, really see something I like. But as of now, just not feeling it, guys. I know it's best if we just walk away from the charts and call it a day at this loss here on QQQ. Unfortunate, but it is what it is, guys. You know, this trade was looking very well or very good. And, you know, I just got stopped out. So, it is what it is, man. I'll keep you guys updated. Okay, guys, it is about 1:18 p.m. You know, no trades since that one loss this morning. The one loss there on QQQ this morning. You know, as you can probably tell by the chart, there hasn't been any crazy, crazy moves today. Kind of just a slow grind to the upside. So, you know, we really haven't missed out on anything. AMD actually did rip like crazy today, honestly, probably because Nvidia has been going so crazy. But yeah, guys, it's pretty much it for now. I'll keep you guys updated throughout the day, man. Probably won't take any more trades if the market continues to trade like this all day. Okay, guys, it is about 2:38 p.m. right now. No more trades have been taken on the day. I honestly might just call today here for trading. This may be the last trading clip. I'm just going ahead and back testing right now on my MacBook. Just, you know, my strategy and, you know, something that I need to be doing and implementing to my actual live trading while backtesting, because my backtesting win rate is crazy, right? And I am using bigger stop losses, but it's not like I'm like using some crazy big stop loss. But what I need to be doing while using this strategy and my stop loss is that I need to be waiting for these retests. I mean, we literally have kind of a perfect setup here on SPY for that retest. You know, when we broke through this level here, waiting and you know, staying patient to come for us to come get a pullback and then going to see if we held that level. And then once we got that confirmation that we're going to hold this level, that would have been a perfect place to place our stop loss underneath. These are the kind of setups that we need to be waiting patiently for. Just because we see that big breakthrough doesn't mean, oh, you know, that's kind of an emotional response or reaction too, is seeing us getting this breakthrough, closing that candle, and just getting right in. No, what I need to be doing is staying patient and waiting for that pullback, that retest, whether we're playing it up or down, and, you know, really setting our stop loss. Like I said, right below this level would have been a perfect area for a stop loss. It would have been beautiful entry for calls. As you can see, we literally rode this all the way up. So that's kind of something I think I've noticed while backtesting, and I'm kind of, you know, still journaling while I'm backtesting, writing things down that work, writing things down that don't work, stuff like that. That's what's so good about backtesting. It builds your confidence and stuff like that for the actual live charts. And yeah, guys, so that's pretty much going to be it for the live trading today, though. Ended right on the day, guys. You know, I'm working on it, guys. I'm trying my best here, and, you know, like, I kind of feel lost right now, and I kind of just don't know where I'm going wrong, but I also, at the same time, am backtesting and, you know, reviewing my trade, just helping me realize where I'm going wrong. And we really just have to keep continuing to show up every day and keep continuing to be better every day, or at least trying to, and, you know, never giving up. You know, it's hard. Trading is hard, but the end result is so worth it. And if you want it bad enough, you know, all the losses won't even matter when you're winning. In the end, we will win. So that's how it's going to be. That's my mindset. That's my mentality. I'll never give up with trading. We made it this far. We've came this far. We're really not that far from being profitable. I know it's coming soon. We just have to continue to put in that work. And, you know, the journey takes longer for some people than others. So that's how it is, guys. You can't expect overnight results. Can't expect to get rich and make millions off trading so quickly, so soon. And that's a false perception people have when they come into trading and the overall game. So that's all I really have to say right now. I'll keep you guys updated throughout the day. I'll probably just gonna be back testing and just kind of chilling.
Okay, guys, it is about 4:21 p.m. Just been chilling, guys. Been back testing. Literally, I've been back testing this whole time. This strategy, starting to get a hang of it, and I'm starting to know, like, build my confidence a little bit more, and knowing what I have to look out for and what I have to stay patient for and disciplined for before entering a trade. I'm gonna be explaining that later, guys. But right now, I'm just gonna continue to keep back testing. About to go ahead and just move to my kitchen and just chill there and just continue to back test, guys. Okay, guys, it's almost about 9 p.m. right now. I've literally just been backtesting this whole time since the last clip. I know I haven't given you guys an update in a little bit, but that's what we've been up to. I've just been backtesting my MacBook, actually, in my kitchen, not down in my room. I'm about to leave for the gym here in about 30 minutes. So that's probably what you'll see next after this clip, guys. I'm continuing to just backtest the strategy, build my confidence up, and we honestly might even be taking a step back with trading and going over to paper trading until we can really get this strategy down. And I can really show myself I can be consistently profitable again over a month's time, or even 2 months, however long it takes, guys, because the end result's so worth it, guys. Even though, you know, recently I've been doing too well, been kind of, you know, taking a toll on me, kind of just been disappointed. It sucks when I see myself putting so much work and effort into something and then it just continue to fail, but that's all part of the process. I know eventually it's going to work out, guys. And also, we just started this year so strong, and I was hopefully, you know, I was thinking that, you know, we finally got trading down, you know, I can finally be profitable, and then see myself just go to shit this month and not have the best month kind of took a toll on me also, guys. But I'm still working at it, I'm still getting at it, guys. So I'll teach you guys when I get to the gym. All right, what is going on, YouTube? Welcome to the back portion of this vlog. About to go ahead and hit some lateral pull downs, and then after that I'll probably go ahead and hit pull-ups. I have 120 on here right now, 6 to 10 rep range. I was just watching the last YouTube video, seeing what we were doing last time, and that's what we had it on, I think, for our last set. We actually might be able to go up in weight, but I'm just go ahead and start with this. Hold up. All right, guys, go ahead and get the second set in. I think that 120 is like the perfect weight for us, because I still want to be able to control it and still have my form right. So I think it's perfect. So let's go ahead and get the second set in.
Alright guys, go ahead and get the next set in. Went ahead and dropped it down to 110 for the last set. So yeah, let's go ahead and get it in. Alright guys, go ahead and get the first set in here for pull-ups. I want at least 5 to 6. Yeah, let's get it.
Fuck that shit. Fuck no.
Nah, low-key, fuck that shit. Holy hell. I can't even barely do that. We might go over to this other bar over here and hit it on this one. Alright guys, go ahead and get the second set in here for pull-ups. I'm sorry that first set was a little bit scuffed. Really wasn't even, I don't even count as a set to be honest, but let's just go ahead and get the second set in. These pull-up sets are so mid and this pull-up bar is like way too short for me, I'm sorry. These pull-ups are kind of scuffed. Alright guys, go ahead and get in the last set for these pull-ups. Kind of scuffed like I said, but fuck it. Should we hit these? Nah, fuck. I feel like the wide grip is low-key better. They're harder and I feel like it's like one of the grip styles most people can't do because they don't hit it, probably because it's one of the hardest, so in my opinion. So let's go ahead and get it in. I fucking honestly hate pull-ups so much, guys, but that's going to be it for pull-ups. I'm going to go ahead and take a piss, and then we'll move it to the next machine. Alright, let's go ahead and get the first set in. I have a 45 and 25 on each side, so yeah, let's go ahead and get the first set in. Alright guys, go ahead and get the second set in. I went ahead and threw in a 5, so we got 45, a 25, and a 5, so let's get it in. Yes. Okay, guys, go ahead and get the last set in for this, and after this, we'll probably move it to the T bar. All right, guys, go ahead and get the first set in here for T-bar rows. I got a 45, a 10, and also a 5 on here to start out the first set, so let's go ahead and get it in. Bro, oh my God, it's fucking hit my knee on this shit, bro, fuck. All right, guys, go ahead and get the next set, and I still got the same weight on here, so let's go ahead and get it in. Okay, guys, go ahead and get the last set in. I have a 45 and a 10. Went ahead and took the 5 off. Really not that much of a difference, but you guys know if you lift, I'm definitely gonna be able to tell that the difference that, you know, the 5 is in here with the last set. So let's go ahead and get it in. Alright, guys, go ahead and get the first set in for this. I'm not sure what it's called. I guess I think it's just a row machine. I'm about to be hitting this one at the top, though. I have a 45 and also a 35 on each side right now. I want to be going heavy, bro. I don't want to be going light. I want to be going heavy and for low rep, heavy weight. But I still want to be able to control the weight fairly decently, like I've been saying, if you guys have been watching my previous videos. So let's go ahead and get the first set in. Okay, guys, going to get the second set in. I still have the 45 and the 35 on 5 to 10 rep range. Just go ahead and get it in, guys. there's something in my fucking arm right here that's getting like pulled, bro. Every single fucking time I do this shit, bro, and it fucking hurts, bro. I don't want to pull anything. I don't know what the fuck it is, bro, but that shit does not feel good. Fuck, bro. All right, guys, going to get the last set for this. Shit, man, I low-key meant to drop the weight. Low-key might just put a 25 on for the last set. Let me take the 35s off real quick. Fuck, should have been doing that when I was just sitting on my ass, but let's go ahead and change that shit. All right, let's go ahead and get it in. 45 and a 25 for the last set. Okay, let's go ahead and get the first set in here for rear delts. I have 90 pounds on right now, so let's go ahead and get it in. Okay, guys, let's go ahead and get the second set in here. Still got the same weight on here, 90 pounds, so let's go ahead and get it in. Okay, guys, go ahead and get the last set in here, and then after this, I'm gonna go ahead and hit the studio room, and then we'll be headed home. So let's go ahead and get it in. Okay, we're gonna try our best to pose in this bathroom here because, bro, someone in the studio room is taking their sweet ass time in there. I waited for like 10 minutes. Fuck that shit. I'm not waiting any longer. I don't know what they're doing in there, but yeah, might be kind of scuffed in here. But let's just see if we can get a good back pump shot in here, whatever you wanna call it. Let's get it. Bro, fuck tonight, bro. First of all, I'm trying to get into the studio room to get poses for the back shots, right? Like, okay, that sounds so, okay, pause. I'm trying to get into the studio room to get the back pump pose, and bro, I'm waiting there for at least 10 minutes, and when I walk up, someone's already been in there. So who knows how long they've already been in there, and you're only supposed to be in there 15 minutes, right? So I'm like, okay, let me just wait. I wait 10 minutes. I'm like, okay, fuck this, I'm not waiting any longer. I go over to this small bathroom that has the mirror that I guess maybe I'll put in this video the shots I got. The mirror was too small. I walk back over to the studio room to see if there's someone still in there. They're still in there, bro. I'm like, fuck this, I'm leaving, bro. And then I leave, and guess what, guys? I left my fucking keys in the bathroom. And luckily, this door to get actually like just into the mall part, not into the actual gym, was unlocked. Because if that shit wasn't unlocked, I actually might have been fucked, and who knows how long I would have been fucking waiting here, right? So I'm waiting for someone to come out to the gym, bro, and it's just like been such an ass night, bro. Luckily someone came out and they got my keys for me. Shout out to that guy, thank you so much. Wow, tonight's just been a fucking it's just kind of been ass, guys. I can't believe, I'm sorry I didn't get a shot in the studio room, guys. I'm not waiting around, I'm just trying to get home, get this leg day video edited, guys. So I'll just hit you guys when I get home.
All right guys, about 1:39 a.m. right now. Went ahead and actually finished the leg day finally. Let me refocus this. Yeah guys, went ahead and finished the leg video. It is rendering right now. I'm about to go ahead and actually probably make this protein shake, and then I'll probably go ahead and brush my teeth, wash my face, all that good stuff, get ready for bed guys. And while this is running, maybe do some more back testing on the charts, which I've actually been doing so much of tonight. Literally my day off, I spent the whole day just back testing. And we're probably honestly gonna be taking a step back with trading and paper trading. This new strategy, and just until we get the hang of this, guys, you know, it's okay to just take a step back, guys. It's part of the process. This just takes patience, consistency, and I'm going to keep showing up every day, no matter how many steps we have to take back, because in the end, we're going to win. We're going to get it, guys. So keep you guys updated before I go to bed. The bulk is actually going crazy, guys. Like, I've eaten so much today. Two bowls of cereal, 4 meatball subs, I think like 5 scoops of ice cream and some other stuff as well. Now we've got this protein shake. Look how full this is. I put 3 scoops of ice cream in here, protein powder, milk, and yeah, that's it. But the bulk is going crazy. Oh yeah, and we ate rice and chicken when we got home. But yeah, this bulk is going absolutely crazy, guys. Let's go ahead and get this slammed down. It's almost about 2 a.m. right now, but fuck it. Okay guys, it is almost 2:30 a.m. right now. I went ahead and I actually got the video rendered. I think I already said that. Got it uploaded. So with that being said, guys, it's gonna be it for the video. Thank you guys so much for making it to the end. If you guys did watch the whole video, y'all some real ones for real. Again guys, I say this every video, but I really do appreciate all the support and the love you've guys been showing on the recent videos. Keep it up guys, it means a lot to me, it means a lot to the channel guys. We're gonna keep going crazy with the vlogs. You know, just uploaded vlog 100 I think yesterday, the time I'm recording this. So that's what's up guys, let's keep it going man. If you guys are new, make sure that like and subscribe button. Thanks again for watching guys, and as always, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.